Hi, my name is Clarence, and welcome to our third video about nursing topics here in Canada. This is for foreign nurses, or also called as IENs, internationally educated nurses, including the Filipinos. Previously in nursing topics, in my first video, I talk about the first three must know of IENs like us. In my second video, I talk about the NNAS assessment phase 1, which is mainly about creating an NNAS account, starting an application, paying those application, and the next step from there. And for today's video, it's about the second stage of NNAS assessment, which is submission of forms and other documents. In this video, we will be talking about three main topics, which are the NNAS forms and other documents, and the personal tips that I can give based on how I did my NNAS. Secondly, the cost of this NNAS stage. And thirdly, what can we expect after this NNAS stage? Let me first tell you that the NNAS forms will only be available in your NNAS account once you have successfully paid the required fees. After that, they can be available for download. Also, we have two scenarios. If suppose you're still in your home country doing your NNAS, just print the forms and go to your respective institutions. The second scenario is, if you can't do it by yourselves because you are out of the country and someone will do this on your behalf, you have three options. Number one, print and manually sign the forms and send it via courier. Secondly, print, manually sign the form, scan, and send it via email. The third option is download the form, electronically sign it, and send it via email. I am hoping that these options did not change as of this year, year 2021, but if in doubt, you can always contact the NNAS customer service. Either ways, NNAS must receive the following documents, which are Nursing Education Form, Nursing Registration Form, Nursing Practice or Employment Form, and lastly, Proof of Identity Documents. Keep in mind that among these four, the only documents that you will submit by yourself is the Proof of Identity Documents. The other three will not be submitted by you, but by the respective institutions, including your school, your employers, and the institution for your nursing registration. Let's first talk about the nursing education form. This is a sample NNAS education form. Once you have downloaded this and have it printed, this section will be auto-answered based on the information that you have provided when you were creating your NNAS account. It is very important that the details here are correct, and if not, you can always go back to your NNAS account and edit it again. The next section will be your signature and the date. The bottom section of each NNAS forms will consist of your name, the order number, the name of the institution who will submit the forms and other documents, the date you created your NNAS account, and then the page number. The succeeding pages are for the school to fill up, but let's focus on page 3. As mentioned here, aside from the NNAS forms, your school will have to submit following: Nursing Education Official Transcript, Program Curriculum, and Course Syllabus. In my opinion, and I guess for most IENs who have completed their NNAS, they will agree that A comprehensive and detailed course syllabus will give you a better chance of getting a good NNAS report. So it is most likely that it will consist of multiple pages, for some 100 pages or more. Now, let's proceed to nursing registration form. As you can see here, I have two sets of NNAS nursing registration form. One for my license in the Philippines, the other is from my previous registration in Saudi Arabia. For my PRC, it was taken care of by someone I know who is working there. She just asked me to send to her a copy of my PRC documents, such as my PRC ID and board certificate. And then finally, it was completed by PRC, so she sent me a picture of this envelope where all my documents were inside, including the NNAS forms. Now for my Saudi Council verification, I benefited from our social community in Facebook, wherein I was so lucky to know someone who helped me with my Saudi verification. So I highly suggest that you join Facebook community of IENs, which will definitely be a big help. So again, the first page of the registration form has been auto-answered by NNAS, but the rest of the pages will be answered or signed by the respective institution. Aside from the NNAS forms, I was asked to send a copy of the following. For the nursing employment forms, I have three sets of forms because I declared three nursing experiences. One was filled up and signed by my previous supervisor, and the other two by the respective human resource department of my previous employers. Also, it will help if you will ask them to add a copy of your job description. Why? I don't know if this applies to all regulatory boards, but in my case, in Ontario, in my CNO application, they are asking for it for my one specific employer. Now let's go to the proofs of identity documents. I must submit two types of identity documents directly to NNAS. These are the acceptable proof of identity documents by NNAS. All documents must be valid and not expired. Also, at least one of your identity documents must have your photo. If you are inside Canada, notarized copies must be prepared by a notary public or a lawyer. If you are outside Canada, it can be done by a government approved official. They must also include the following in each of your identity documents. These documents must be written in English. If not, they must be translated by an approved source agency of NNAS. Now, for the cost of this NNAS phase, I can't give you a definite amount. It is for sure that most institutions will ask for a processing fee. You may also pay a representative service fee. Hire the service of someone in doing this on your behalf, especially if you have previous experience in the Middle East. Please remember that we only have 1 year to complete our NNAS application. I'm always saying in my previous blogs that please know your timeline because this is not a cheap process. But once all the documents were received by NNAS, we just have to wait for the issuance of the NNAS result in the form of an advisory report. So if suppose you have two applications in NNAS, you will be receiving two advisory reports. We will be talking about more about this topic on our next video about nursing. And that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.